Universal. The reason I chose that name is that I believe on the unification of Africa, and then Rhandzanani is the Tsonga word, which means we must love each other.
Rhandzanani,
when it comes to Sizulu's cause, that means Tandanani ma Africa. That Rhandzanani is not only for certain people, as in certain province or state in the continent. It's the whole continent. We should love each other as one. So I call it Rhandzanani Movement Clothing, because it's a movement in a sense that I try, with a product, we try to preach the unification of the continent.
That
when I started printing, I started 2004. I think it was around October. Yes, it was around October 2004. I was coming back from Mozambique, and then this is therapy. Sorry for that. It's great, man. Life is politics. It's great, but at the same time, it's challenging when you look at politics, you know. But it's okay. But as the economy went down, and it comes to my challenge. But I still see green future. I call it green future. I call it bright future. But hey, please allow me to see. I see green future, because bright future to me, bright to me doesn't show good things coming out, because white clouds that don't bring the rain, only dark clouds that bring the rain. So allow me to say we'll edit it, but yeah. I don't like saying clear. How to say bright future, and it's green future, because green is life, and Africa is green. So I see green future, but at the moment, for sure, I got to be honest, business it's quite slow. Actually down by more than 50% if I look at from summer season last year. In fact, from Grahamstown last year, it was down by more than 50%, and summer season was also down by more than 50%. But I still see my aim. Okay. Printing these faces is to thank them and to remember them. And then to pay big respect on them, because they contributed and they're still contributing in my freedom and fellow African freedom, although we're not yet free. So we need to remember them so that we can carry on with struggle until we're free. So we're free in certain areas, but it's lots of areas that we're not free. So we cannot forget them. We're trying to remember them and thank them at the same time, and teach others about our great leaders, so that we can carry on with. Maybe we can follow in their footsteps. Hey, I'm an African kid, man, and I love my people, I love my continent. The Rhandzanani Movement is to grow big and then create jobs for our fellow Africans and training skills for our fellow Africans. That's the future of Rhandzanani. Well, not only skills as in to make money, but to think, planning things, how to behave. Those who drink must slow down drinking. Those who smoke, just. Because if this Rhandzanani come, the movement that we then have a studio or a workshop that will work, I'll be telling those who smoke to stop smoking. Those who drink, to slow down drinking. So it's not only about getting skills to be trained and make money, because you can make money but not do anything good with that money. I know I work with people, get them, get paid, and they're worth that money. So it's also to conscientize people as to how to behave even in our society, as we face with crime and all that, rapes and stuff. So it's to grow business-wise, economically and spiritually, and can I say consciously, socially? That's my wish. It's where I would like to see Rhandzanani Movement do from here, Cape Town, where I live, and the whole South Africa and the whole African continent, if I could. And it will happen, actually. It will happen as long as I'm still alive. And I've got you, my brothers and sisters, who are supporting. You know, this is ours.